This is the Zeel programmer. Just basically connects. That switch there switches between ignition map 1 and ignition map 2. So I can have two maps and switch between them on the fly. And this one here switches between two power valve maps. I was going to do a video about setting up the carbs, but I can't do that because I've lost all the thread in my wheel nut. I've got new BT090s on my bike right now, which is great, but I can't get the rear spindle done up, so I can't ride it. So the best way of warming the bike up is for taking it for a ride. I can't do that. So I'm going to have a look at the Zeeltronic that I've got fitted. Now, what is a Zeeltronic? It's a custom ignition unit. I suppose it's a little bit unfair to say it's just an ignition unit because it looks after the power valves, the air solenoids, and there's a whole host of other extras as well. So I've got that because I want to de-restrict my TZR 3XV. All TZR 3XVs, apart from very special variants, are restricted to either 45 or 40 brake horsepower. And there's a number of ways that they are restricted, but one of them is by the CDI unit. So by replacing it with a Zeeltronic CDI unit, I can now take that Japanese market restrictions off my bike and see what would a 3XV be like if they ever did import them into the UK. So that's what the plan is. Where I got my Zeeltronic from, I got it from the Tuning Works, and it's really handy getting it from the Tuning Works because what Sean there does is he fits the connectors to it. If you buy it direct from Zeeltronic, it doesn't have the connectors fitted. You have to source those and fix that. So that's really good, really good quality job. And you can see how I've installed the Zeeltronic there. You'll see there's loads of extra wires, and those are for doing extra things. I've used some of those features, so I will show you about those features. So some of the extras that I've got installed on this comes with the Zeel, but what I've got is I'll show you here. That switch there switches between ignition map 1 and ignition map 2, so I can have two maps and switch between them on the fly. And this one here switches between two power valve maps. The other extra thing that I've got wired in is this guy here, which is a shift light. I've currently got that set to 5000 RPM. We'll change that in a minute when I show you the Zeel software. But I'll just show you the power valve. So if we go down here, you can see the power valve there at the very bottom. If I just flick the switch, you can see that moving. I'll show you on the upper one as well. Flick the switch, and that's the power valve moving. So that's what I've got wired in on my Zeeltronic. And the next question is, what ignition map should I be using? The Zeeltronic comes with two maps for the TZR. In fact, it might actually be more than that. We'll have a look in a minute. Comes with a few maps for the TZR 3XV, and I don't really want to use those straight away. I want to understand a bit more about how the restrictions work on the Japanese market. And let's go to my favorite place, which is pure2strokespirit.net, the TZR forum, where there's loads of information about this. Let's go and let's have a look at it now. Right, this is where I come to get all the information I need about my TZR. TZR forum, pure2strokespirit.net. Those are really helpful people, very passionate about all sorts of TZRs. It's also backed up by a lot of information that you won't find anywhere else. Lots of parts lists, manuals, things like that. It's in Japanese mostly, but that's okay because people have done translations. You can use Google Translate, and a lot of the really important things are numbers anyway, so you can kind of work out what you need to do. Just point Google Translate at this, and it will tell you that's probably float height. So I can see the car, main jets, things like that. It's pretty straightforward. So these are the people that have done the research that I'm going to rely on to set up my Zeeltronic. So this member here, Jürgen, did a fantastic job, to be honest. Got hold of loads and loads of different CDIs, bench tested them, and worked out what those CDIs were actually doing, what signals they were sending to set the ignition timing, to set the power valve opening, controlling the air solenoids, all this stuff. And what I've done here is I've just lifted the 100% throttle position against RPM for these various CDIs. Now, what do the CDIs mean? Forum founder YBK has done this helpful chart here that says all the different variants of TZR3XV, what the model designations are. So I've got an RS, which is a 3XV8, and it tells you also what CDI it's got. So that's got a 3XV40, and some have got a Sugo CDI as well. So this SP has a 3XV10 CDI as road standard, and then a 3XV70 CDI in unrestricted format. So what did Yamaha do to restrict all of these? And you can see 45 brake horsepower for the early ones, and then the later ones were restricted even further to 40 itself. So plotting all these numbers here, I've also taken a look at the Sugo ones and plotted the numbers there, so we can take a look and see what that means. Okay, so here's the restricted lot. As you can see, all the curves start to bring back the advance around about 8,000 RPM, and then they pretty much drop quite quickly, and there's nothing left by about 11,500. Let's contrast that to the ignition curves for the unrestricted CDIs, and you see they hang on to their advance much, much longer. When they do start to bring it back a bit for safety's sake, around 9,000 RPM, but they do hang on to this a lot. So that's part of the restriction, is that bringing down the advance brings down the power, and this brings down the advance purely for safety, really, so you don't pop your motor. Using this information, I can look at the standard maps that Borut gives on the Zeeltronic, and they're great maps. But what I want to do is I don't want to go flat out from the get-go, because I want to set this up on a dyno properly. So just an understanding of what's going on between these two maps will help me set up the Zeeltronic and make sure that it is not restricted, but equally it's safe. So I don't want to go as extreme as these, but I do want to remove some of the restriction. So when I take it to the dyno, it's kind of in the ballpark, and we can sort the carburation out and the ignition out from there. We'll plug in the Zeel, show you how that works. So let's get the Zeeltronic connected, sitting in the bike. Extension cable, an absolute must. If you don't have that, then you can see you'll never be able to plug it in without taking the whole bike apart. So this is the Zeel programmer, just basically connects into here, and then connects into the laptop. Any small Windows laptop will do. This is the smallest one I could find. So it's now saying connected. And what's really important about this is you actually press the read button first, because if you look at all these numbers, they're all 15 degrees on the ignition maps. Everything's not right. So you need to hit read. And that's going to read it from the Zeel on the bike and get all the values. Let's wait for that to verify. Okay, now you can see here I've got my ignition maps shown, and I did say that I had a switch to do two ignition maps. That red button I showed you, and here are the two that I've shown you. So we start off with different settings depending on where your throttle is. So if you've got your throttle closed, it runs off this ignition map. Up to two-thirds open, it's this map. 100%, it's this map. And everything is linearly interpolated. Do you know what? It's a straight line between the two points. So if you've got 19 at 2000 RPM and 21 at 3000 RPM, then at 2500 RPM, it's going to be 20. The same goes across all here. So on my particular installation, you see I've got an ignition map switch. All of these values are set for the 3XV. If I go to the power valve maps, you can see I've got a power valve map switch. So that's set up. These settings here are really, really tricky to get hold of. The open position and the closed position. I've known people who have got these values completely wrong and twisted the power valve around. So just really go cautious on those to start with. So, you know, 200, 500, something like that, really cautious. You can set these up. You can just change the value and then hit test open, test close. And you can see if it's moving any further. So you can just fine tune the angle there. But here's my two power valve maps. So the first map, I have the power valve open at the very start and then closed. So basically a 1000 RPM, the engine's running. So it closes the power valve. And the other one's exactly the same. But the difference is map one has the power valve open for starting. Map two has it closed. And I find that having the power valve open for starting is a little bit easier because it reduces the compression. Solenoid output, I'm getting into some real cool stuff here, but essentially in the 3XV, it has two sets of air solenoids for entering bleed air in for fine-tuning the motor. Through the rev range and different throttle settings and things like that, way beyond my skill set, so I'm not going to worry about that too much. And then here's my shift light, and I said I was going to change that, so I'm going to change that to 11,000 RPM. Okay, and it's the rev limit as 12,000, so the shift light basically does what it says on its tin. It says shift, and then the rev limiter comes in from Zeeltronic, and so that will put the candles out if you're going too far. TPS as well, you can calibrate the throttle position sensor. It's on top of the right hand or lower or forward carburetor, but essentially what that does is that tells the Zeeltronic how far open or closed your throttle is. So now I've changed that, let me just program. And so now this is updating the settings. What I'll do is I'll take these ignition numbers and bring them into the spreadsheet so we can take a look and see, you know, where are my numbers looking? Does it look reasonable? Do I need to do any change on those? But I did want to change the shift light. One thing I will do on my power valve maps while I'm here is I actually want to bring this number here down. So if I say 500 RPM is open and 600 RPM is closed, That's fine. Because what I was finding is, let me program that, is that when it was idling, there was just a little fluttering on the power valve. So I think that could have been the idle dropping below 900 between pulses. So that should sort that out as well. Okay, so that's it. I can disconnect that now and we can take a look at the numbers. What I've done is I've put the Zeeltronic maps that I've got on my machine onto the same chart as the Restricted and the Sugo. Just to make this a little bit easier, what I've done is make an average of all of the Restricted CDIs and make an average of all of the Sugo CDIs. So Sugo in red, you can see that's the one that hangs on to its advance for longer, and the Restricted ones in grey, that's the one where it kind of starts to wind out the advance fairly early on in the RPM gauge. My two maps, they're looking very aggressive, so well done Borat, this looks like cracking maps. In some instances, they're a bit more aggressive than the average Sugo. So what I'm going to do is I'm probably just going to bring one of my maps below the Sugo line before running that full throttle in earnest. You'll notice on the beginning, everybody starts at 21 degrees and I've started at 19 degrees with one of my maps. And the reason for that is I get kicked back occasionally. I guess I don't kick it over as enthusiastically as a Japanese teenager in the 80s. So that might be the problem. I'm just kicking it too slow. But I thought 19 just made it start a little bit easier. Let's move this. All right. You see my two maps are tracking okay in the center. And then they're going... they're following an unrestricted path. So that's quite cool. What I'm going to do is just bring this map here, which I'm going to use as my softer map, and bring that underneath the Sugo. But everything else looks pretty good. And definitely, as you can see, I'm running unrestricted CDI now. But the porting work from Martin 77, I should be able to cope with that ignition, but I'll only really find out from the dyno. So that's what I'm going to do. So that's what I need to do with the Zeeltronic, which is excellent, straightforward, I can do that. When it comes to next steps for the bike, first thing I need to do is I need to get the rear wheel spindle nut, which is on order, should arrive sometime during the week. Then I can go for an MOT, get that done. With all that done, I can then ride the bike again and then I can start setting up the carbs. All the fairings are off ready to do this, but it really helps to have the rear wheel connected when you are riding. So kind of a given really. Right, that's it for this one. I'll be back with the spanners next time. Okay, take care.